Hello, my name is Noah Galvis-Doucette, and today we're going to be taking a trip to Turkmenistan.
Economic fallout of the COVID-19 crisis has drastically worsened Turkmenistan's pre-existing food crisis.
The Turkmenistan's president has ordered the extinguishment of the country's gateway to hell, a fire that has been burning for 7 decades in a desert gas crater.
And amid the growing financial crisis, Turkmenistan has unveiled a huge statue of a dog.
According to the local Turkmen geologists, the huge crater that was formed in the 1960s was only lit in the 1980s.
The country of Turkmenistan is bordered by Kazakhstan to the northwest, Uzbekistan to the north and east, Afghanistan to the southeast, Iran to the south, and the Caspian Sea to the west. Currently, this is its flag, and its president is Serdar Bertemuhamedov. Comparatively, Turkmenistan is most similar to Nigeria, with a GDP per capita of 7,344 USD compared to Nigeria's 5,900 USD, a Gini index percentage of 51.1 compared to Nigeria's 35.1, a human development index score of 0.745 compared to Nigeria's 0.527, and no freedom index score, as Turkmenistan is hostile towards journalists, and as such, they haven't been able to get a proper reading on the degree of freedom. However, regarding the regime and structure of government of Turkmenistan, it is most similar to Russia and China. Regarding the executive branch, it has a president who is directly elected for unlimited 7-year terms. However, the president has been accused of being non-democratic, as all 8 of the previous competitors were considered non-competitive by international sources, and all election commissions are directly under the control of the president, hinting at potential election fraud in the last election. Although, the executive branch isn't the only branch that's been considered corrupt by international sources. The legislative branch of Turkmenistan is bicameral, with the National Council of Turkmenistan acting as the lower chamber and the Mejlis acting as the upper chamber. The Mejlis is composed of 125 member seats directly elected from individuals, whereas the National Council of Turkmenistan is a 56 people's council. The leader of the National Council of Turkmenistan is in fact the former president of Turkmenistan and father of the current president of Turkmenistan, leading to claims of nepotism and fraud in regards to the elections, especially when considering the fact that the election of Gurbanguly Berdimuhamedov was behind closed doors. Just as the legislature is similar to Russia, so too is the judicial branch similar to Russia and China, in that it is also expected to be corrupt. All judges are directly appointed by the president, and as such, all judges follow effectively his rules. Also, many of the punishments doled out to criminals are considered to be inhumane, and methods such as torture for the extraction of information are permitted in Turkmenistan. In regards to social movements and the media, most non-governmental organizations are suppressed for fear of their corrupting influence on young Turkmens. No more poignant example of this exists than when in 2006, the government of Turkmenistan banned video games as a whole for fear of their effects on the youth. Media organizations are similarly suppressed or under the control of the executive branch, and more specifically, the president. Two major social cleavages exist in Turkmenistan: religion and ethnicity. In regards to religion, despite being a secular state, Turkmenistan still has multiple laws in place to ensure that all religions are upheld to a similar doctrine. Minor religions that are found practicing without registering first with the government may have members subject to beating and imprisonment, whereas more major religions, such as Islam, have specific doctrines laid out by the government that must be preached, otherwise similar punishments may follow. In regards to ethnicity, all non-Ahal citizens are treated as second class, and women on average find more discrimination, especially in political positions. While these social cleavages already highlight similarities to both Russia and China, another similarity with China is shown through Turkmenistan's willingness to jail and imprison political rivals and members of ethnicities that have spoken out against the government. Finally, in comparing Turkmenistan to its nearest neighbor, Iran, we see interesting similarities in its statistics, but differences in their systems of government and election systems. For instance, the Gini index of Iran is 40.9%, and the Human Development Index is 0.774. Two statistics that are both very similar to Turkmenistan. However, in Iran, the legislative branch is unicameral, and the executive branch is split between the supreme leader and the president. These differences highlight differences in governance, likely due to the fact that Turkmenistan was once under the control of the Soviet Union. Meanwhile, proving itself both as a rentier state and also an ally of China, perhaps explaining some of its similarities with the country, Turkmenistan's closest trade relationship is with the Republic of China, trading in natural gas and oil. This relationship is mirrored by the United States, Turkey, and many other Western European countries who buy exports from Turkmenistan, in exchange bolstering the country's economy. Now for some fun facts about Turkmenistan. Besides in 2006 attempting to ban all video games, it was also once illegal to seek medical aid anywhere except for the capital of Turkmenistan. This coming into contrast with the fact that the majority of the population are rural farmers living in effectively the middle of nowhere. Also, the original president of Turkmenistan, Niyazov, decided to erect a 39-foot gold statue of himself in the middle of the capital of Turkmenistan, known as the Monument of Neutrality, while his citizens were suffering from economic decline as a result of failed shock therapy. This has since been taken down. However, the current president of Turkmenistan has since decided to erect a second gold statue, this time of his favorite dog breed. Niyazov also wrote a book that was mandatory reading for every elementary to university student of Turkmenistan until he banned all libraries. Of course, all of this pales in comparison to what I'm about to show you next. Known as the Darvaza gas crater, or the Door to Hell, or Gates of Hell, this crater was created during a Soviet mining accident when they believed they were drilling for oil instead of natural gas. Here is an artistic rendition of the Darvaza gas crater. As you can now see, the real thing isn't that far off. Of course, this is only the second most crazy thing to happen in Turkmenistan, as recently, the president of Turkmenistan, in an attempt to disprove a hoax about his death, decided to drive donuts around the front of it. As should be clear by now, Turkmenistan is a very interesting country, with a number of quirks, but also a number of similarities to other AP comparative government countries. Namely, much of its government system seems to take, or at least be very similar to, Russia and China, which is unsurprising considering its previous state as a member of the Soviet Union. It also shares a number of similarities with the country of Nigeria, which is again not surprising considering their status as both rentier states and also as mostly developing nations, progressing out of a predominantly agricultural focus towards a focus on exports of oil and natural gases. Its main trading partner is the country of China, and its most similar neighbor is Iran, especially in statistics. Thank you for watching this presentation on the very interesting country of Turkmenistan. I hope you've learned something, and I have been Noah Galvez-Doucette.